If you're anything like me, you may feel like there's always more to learn about a given topic despite the amount of time that you've already invested learning about it. Canning, for example, is something that I've been doing for years, but I feel like there's so much more to learn and I'm constantly learning about new tips and tricks. Today, I'm going to share with you 10 tips I wish I had known before I started canning. Number one, make sure you plan a time to get started. Some canning projects can take minutes, others can take hours. It just depends on what you're canning and of course the quantity or the volume of the items that you're canning. Once you've determined approximately how much time you'll need, make sure you schedule a start time. That way you'll be freed up if you have appointments later on in the day or if you happen to have narcolepsy, as my husband swears that I do, and your brain happens to shut down around 8 o'clock. I always make sure that I am done with my canning far before that, as the more tired you are, the more likely you are to make mistakes. Next, make sure you prepare your equipment and your ingredients in advance. Making a jelly or a jam only to find out that you don't have any pectin is not very convenient, or preparing a huge batch of homemade chili only to find out that you're out of lids is incredibly inconvenient. So definitely check to make sure you have everything and get it prepared in advance, because that's going to help you to become more efficient with that process and also ensure that you have everything that you need before you get started. Plan for storage. One thing that may not come to mind immediately is that once you've canned all this food, you need a place to put it. You need to have a relatively cool, dark place to store your canned food. And if it ends up that you have to store it under your bed, upstairs in your master bedroom, that works, but it's definitely not very convenient if you have to run up there every time you're making a meal. Determine where to can. If it's hot outside, can outside if you can. Can if you can. If it's cold outside, can inside the house. When it's 100 degrees outside, the last thing you want to do is overheat the interior of your house. And on the flip side, when it's really cold outside, if you're going to be canning anyway, you may as well do it inside, because the heat from your stove can help to contribute to the heat within your house as well. Buy ingredients that are in season. When fruits and vegetables are in season, they're much more abundant, which means you can get them for a better price generally. And then they also are much more fresh at that time, ensuring that you're getting a product that is much higher quality than something that is no longer in season. Can what you grow, or grow what you can. Either way, if you have the ability to grow the items in your garden that you're wanting to can, that can really cut down on the cost of canning. It also can help you to produce a much more delicious ingredient for the items that you're canning. My most favorite canned item is boiled peanuts, and raw peanuts are not always easy to come by. So I ended up buying a packet of peanuts from Baker Creek Heirloom Seed Company, and I planted those, multiplied them, planted them again, multiplied them again, and basically multiplied them enough to a point where I can boiled peanuts until my heart is content. Many tomato and pepper plants even can be planted in pots that can be stored on your porch or in your window, and are a great option if you don't happen to have a large amount of space to grow a garden. Can what you like and what you'll use. When it comes to canning, you want to process foods that you enjoy eating. And then you also want to make sure that you're not canning so much that you're unable to use it. I have about 30 jars of pickled daikon sitting in my pantry right now, and I only have one recipe that I actually use them in, so I know I won't be able to use them all before they go bad. That means I have a great idea for Christmas gifts for the family. Next, do not follow the recipe. Okay, hold on. I know that probably sounds a little bit hypocritical because I probably told you in the 20 canning mistakes to avoid video to follow the recipe, but I should have elaborated a little bit further. I'm not saying here that you need to throw out the entire recipe completely. It's really important that you're following the processing times and temperatures and pounds of pressure. And then also if you're swapping out any ingredients, you want to make sure that you're not lowering the acidity levels that are needed when you're water bath canning, for example. So those items are still important and you want to stick to those, but don't be afraid to change out some of the ingredients. If you don't like cilantro, leave the cilantro out. That's perfectly fine. There are different spices and flavors that you can change up to make sure that it tastes good to you. For example, if you want something more spicy, throw in more jalapeno. That's perfectly fine. Taste test. I'm not saying you should taste test the chicken when you're raw packing your jars, but you should be tasting any of the foods that have been cooked or are ready to eat. And if it doesn't taste good before you're canning, then it's not going to taste good after you've canned it. Find a canning buddy. Finding somebody who enjoys canning as much or more as you do can be very rewarding. Not only can it help to cut down on some of that initial expense that is associated with canning, but it can also make it a lot more fun. If you find somebody who is also interested in canning, they may have some of the equipment that you don't have and vice versa, and you can share so that you both don't have to invest in those items separately. And then of course, having somebody to help you process 100 pounds of tomatoes is a lot more fun than trying to do that all on your own. Those are my 10 tips for today. If you have more tips to share, please drop them in the comments. I look forward to learning more. Thank you and happy canning.